Every PDM vault has a workflow at the heart of it, controlling revisions, permissions, and helping to keep files organized. But how well do you know your workflow? Here are our top 10 tips to help you add more power and control into this crucial system. It is generally bad practice to have users approving their own work. By enabling disallow sequential state change in the transition permissions, you block users from moving a file through two transitions sequentially. Every time you check in a file with changes, it creates a new version in the history. This allows any previous version to be viewed or recovered at a later date. If your workflow transition makes a change to a file, for instance updating a variable, it will also create a new version. However, creating new versions in this way can begin to take up valuable space in the archives, and these versions often aren't ones which need to be reviewed or recovered. By enabling Overwrite Latest Version in the transition options, the old version will instead be replaced. Be aware that this won't always be the best option, as the old version will no longer be available to roll back to. By default, certain permissions such as delete and move will be considered for every state a file has been in its history. For example, users have permissions to delete a file in the work in progress state, but not in the approved state. If the file has been approved once and is sent back to work in progress, users will still be unable to delete the file. This is ideal in most cases to avoid deleting mature files while still allowing users to delete files which haven't yet moved past the work in progress state. The ignore permissions in previous state setting can be used to override this behaviour, forcing the permissions to only be applied from the current state. In the previous example, if this setting had been turned on, the users would no longer be blocked from deleting the files in the work in progress state. Each PDM account is password protected to maintain security and ensure that actions are recorded against the correct user. However, if you are already logged in and someone were to access your machine, they would be able to carry out transitions as if they were you. The authentication option will require a password to perform the transition, reducing the chance of unauthorized approval. Multiple transitions with the same name can be set up to have one user input send multiple files to different workflow states. For example, a file with the word hardware in the description could go to the hardware workflow state, while other CAD files could be sent to other states based on their conditions. The user only sees one change state option, and the files transition to their respective states during this action. Similarly, files in different states can have transitions with the same name leading to one shared state, which can then be carried out with one change state action. Revision numbers are usually controlled by the state settings. When the revision number value is set to increment by 1, the increment revision command on a transition entering this state will move the file to the next revision. The revision number settings in the transition will override this behavior. So if you have multiple transitions into one state, you don't have to use the same increment settings. This is helpful for an up issue override or minor mod loop, where you would set the revision number to increment by 0 and the files will be re-approved at the same revision. Everything we have talked about so far has been available in PDM Standard, which is included with your SOLIDWORKS Professional subscription. But for PDM professional customers, there's a whole lot more you can do with workflows. You are no longer limited to one workflow, and these will also be more complex, with an unlimited number of states and multiple transitions going between them. You also have access to automatic and parallel transitions, which you can find out more about by watching our handy guide on the different transitions available in PDM Professional. When working across multiple workflows, it is possible to link these together, allowing for compartmentalization of workflow functionality. Workflow link can be created in a similar way to a state in the workflow via the right-click menu or the toolbar icon. Select the workflow and the state where the file will be sent, then click OK. You then need a transition to move the files to the new workflow. Permissions, conditions, actions, and notifications can all be configured as with any transition. In PDM Professional, multiple transitions can go between two states. Similar to our previous tip with multiple transitions named the same, we can set up these transitions to all go into one state. The start and end points will be the same for these files, but we can change the actions and notifications. For example, when moving a part and its drawings to approved, the part has an STL file created through a task, and the R&D team will be notified that they need to 3D print a prototype. The drawing, on the other hand, is sent through a different transition, which updates the revision table and also creates a PDF, then notifies purchasing that the drawing is ready to be sent out for quotes. Parallel transitions are useful when you need more than one user to approve a file. When you are halfway through the approval process, you generally don't want people moving the file through a different transition. And so the setting Hide When Sibling Parallel Transition is Chosen is set by default on all transitions. However, if you need to be able to interrupt the parallel transition to move the file into a different state, you can uncheck this option on any other transitions. We hope you found something useful in this video to help you up your game with PDM workflows. If you want to find out more about any of these features or you're interested in the features provided by PDM Standard or Professional, you can contact our amazing team today.